Today's the Paddlepalooza. So this is the 8th annual event that we're hosting, starting in Auburn Hills and ending in Rochester Hills. So we partner with the city of Rochester Hills and the Clinton River Watershed Council to put on this event.
We have three races. We have a single person, one person kayak race, men's division, one person kayak race, women's division, and then the two person canoe race. And we have a race within a race. We also have the city of Rochester Hills and city of Auburn Hills racing for the Mayor's Cup as well. The event is a great way to let people know what they can do in the river. It shows the value of the river and in turn gives them a reason to protect the river.
So we have this great recreational resource right in our own backyard. Clinton River flows all the way from Waterford out to Lake St. Clair. Between the fishing and the canoeing and kayaking, it's just a great recreational resource outdoors for, you know, everybody to enjoy.
We help with volunteering and we also help organize this event. The Watershed Council has been working for over 40 years. This event in particular is a great opportunity to experience this portion of the river. It is the most challenging and there's a lot of log jams that get caught up here, and we make sure the river is open for everybody to use, and I think it's a great time to come enjoy this.
Oh, we have the Clinton River Canoe and Kayak Rental. They rent all the canoes and kayaks for the participants. This year we have Simple Adventure who are providing guides for the adventure paddle. Genesis Credit Union helping with registration, and Big B Coffee providing coffee for the racers at the beginning, giving them a little bit of energy there. It's a big team effort, and again, this is the best time to get on the river, only because the municipalities have really done a great job of clearing all the debris from the river to make it for a safe passage.
Thanks for coming out. I want to thank all the people, all the staff that came out here. We have a great afternoon. It looks like it's a beautiful weather. I know the river is a little bit low, but we're gonna have a good time, we're gonna have some fun, be safe out there, and thanks a lot for coming out. We appreciate it very much.
The purpose of this is so that all of you get a chance to see this really great treasure that we have and come back and enjoy it more. We also wanna thank, they're not here at the moment, but our first responders, who you'll see along the river on your way to Rivercrest. We've got lifeguards, we've got firefighters, we've got folks just to make sure that everyone has a great experience, and we get a chance to wave at them and thank them for coming out today. We appreciate it too. So enjoy the river and have a great day. Thanks.
It's a really challenging section of the river. The elevation difference from the beginning to the end is pretty steep, so the river runs pretty quickly. The other thing related to the course is there are a lot of bends and turns. So you have a few straightaways, but you really have to know how to navigate your craft. A lot of people who end up at the finish, they basically say that it's almost up in the Asabo, meaning that you're going through, you're not seeing any houses, you're not seeing any businesses and stuff, you're really out in nature.
In 1978, I joined the Morning Optimist Club here in Auburn Hills. In about 1982, we decided that we would take on the river. And so we took it upon ourselves and started cleaning out the river, particularly from Updike Road on down to the park here. About 1985, we actually started borrowing canoes from the Boy Scouts, and we had some canoe river races. And then the city said, we'll help you out, helping to clean the river. I had a heart attack in 2000, and after I recovered, the first thing I did was bought a saw and cleaned up all the trees down by the bridge on Squirrel Road as a celebration that I did that. But the Optimist Club started it, others took after that, and so the river today is really clean. It's purported that our stretch of the river here from Updike to Rochester Hills has more white water than any other river in Michigan, at least in the lower peninsula. I'm not sure about the upper, but this falls so much that when there's a little more water in the river, it's really fun. Paddlepalooza is a dual event. One, it's for those that love to canoe or kayak. From a competitor can come and have a little fun racing. But it also, for the other half, is people coming and enjoying a part of the river which has a good flow and has great scenery and has a place where you can really have fun.
My favorite part about Paddlepalooza is watching the winners come in and talking to everybody about how much they enjoy the river.
Last year we had 130 and it felt like more. So I'm gonna say at least 150 people probably in the water this year. So more people, more fun on the river. Racers just left and our adventure paddlers just took off. So we're gonna head down to Rochester Hills and do our luncheon and give out some awards.